the likes of the late retired General Kiramba to join the liberation struggle in June 1974, crossing into Botswana through Plumtree. Our national hero received early military training at Morogoro Training Camp in Tanzania, where he met our current Commander of Defense Forces, General Philip Valerio Zwanda, with whom he trained from June to November 1974. Having shown his prowess and ability during the initial training, he was among the few cadres selected to undergo the cadet light artillery weapons training between November 1974 and October 1975 in Ukraine, in the then Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, the USSR, now the Russian Federation. At the end of his training in artillery, our departed hero returned to the Morogoro training camp at a time when the two liberation movements, ZANU and ZAPU, merged their fighting units, ZANLA and ZIPRA, into the short-lived Zimbabwe Patriotic Army, ZIPA. Our departed comrade left Morogoro from Gagao, Tanzania, in November 1975. In December 1975, he left Morogoro camp for Dondo in Beira, in Mozambique, under ZIPA, for deployment to the front. The deployment of ZIPA encountered challenges, with combatants reverting to their original fighting units under ZANDA or ZIPA. In the case of a national hero, he joined ZANDA by the end of 1975. He operated under the Nyongwe detachment in Mount Darwin in the Neanda sector, where he was injured in action and then repatriated to Tete province. With his bold and fearless spirit, the late comrade Smangaliso Kumede was redeployed to the battalion administration camp as a logistics officer. He was responsible for the efficient movement of armaments, foodstuffs, clothing for guerrillas in the front line in the Tete province. By 1978, he had distinguished himself in his duties, leading to his promotion to a post in general staff, responsible for operational logistics, until 1979. In the rear, he remained astute, resourceful, versatile, and a responsible cadre who saved for and looked after the strategic armaments and the firepower of our revolution. After independence in 1980, the late Major General played a critical role in the integration of the ZANLA combatants into the Zimbabwe National Army. He was attested into the Zimbabwe National Army in 1980 and promoted to the rank of colonel in April 1981. Thereafter, he was appointed to several command positions, which included commanding officer, Mashonaland Services Corps, commander of Lawyer District, Commander 3 Infantry Brigade, Commander Engineers Corps, and Commander 5 Infantry Brigade, 1993-1996, during which he was promoted to the rank of Brigadier General in 1994. In addition, our national hero commanded two infantry brigades from late 1996 until the beginning of the war in the Democratic Republic of the Congo. He was seconded to that country as Deputy Managing Director, Sanger Mines, and held that position until 2004, when he retired from the Zimbabwe National Army. Upon retirement, he was promoted to the rank of Major General. With his track record of honesty, integrity, and dedication to duty, Comrade Clever Chiramba was again seconded after his retirement to the DRC until 2007. Upon his return to Zimbabwe, he ventured into farming in Karoi, where he specialized in the growing of soybeans, maize, and maize. Although the late hero trained with and deputized commanders who went on to occupy national strategic positions, he never claimed or demanded such association to be a right to access privileges or benefits. Under the Second Republic, proximity or relations with those holding public positions of influence should never be a basis whatsoever to accessing favors or benefits. Comrades, due to his dedication, selfless, and exemplary service to this country, to the nation, and the people of this great country, Comrade Chiramba was accorded several awards and medals. These include the Liberation, Independence of Zimbabwe, Mozambique campaign, as well as the Long and Exemplary Service Medals. Over and above these medals, he earned himself the Grand Officer of Zimbabwe Order of Merit for his eminent achievement and distinguished service and loyalty to his country.